I gave you fair warning. Beware, beware, beware. Gave you fair warning, beware,
yo,
beware.
But you thought punk shit was sweet, now you can't sleep. Gotta keep your eyes open wide and hide your face from the streets. I'm like the beast with a warrant, far from a Norman. Gave you fair warning, now you wanna stand squalling. I'm calling out any rapper that I doubt. Smack him in the mouth, throw him in the yoke, boom, then I knock him out. No doubt, Freddy Fox fouls, 20 shot, auto Glock plow, Benny Black, Porter Rock style.
I gave you fair warning, beware.
Hi, my name is Juan Castro, editor of IGN PSP, and today we're going to be reviewing Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories for the PSP. To start, what we need to say is that GTA on the PSP packs just about everything that fans of the series would want from a console GTA game. The narrative in LCS revolves around Liberty City, the same city as in GTA 3, so players can visit the same three islands as in the PS2 title. Virtually every alleyway, sidewalk, structure from the console version makes an appearance in the handheld version, so it's actually very, very similar, almost identical. The only real differences as far as gameplay goes are due to the game's story. The events in LCS actually take place a number of years before GTA 3, so certain structures such as bridges and tunnels are still under construction. And just like the previous games, the production values rock. The voice work sounds believable and cool, the cutscenes are well directed and really pleasing the story, the music and sound effects are pretty cool too, and of course the game looks damn good, especially considering it's on a handheld. There are certain points of the game where you just kind of stand still and kind of soak it in. You can kind of pan the camera, you see airplanes taking off from airports in the distance, you know, the sun setting, so overall it's visually a very, very impressive game, especially considering the fact that it's on a handheld. The missions themselves offer an eclectic mixture of good, bad, and very terrible missions. And for whatever reason, the best missions in the game kind of clump toward the end of the game, where the bad missions are towards the start. And the reason for that is that the game just feels sort of imbalanced. Like, you'll face the same opposition toward the beginning of the game that you will at the end, only that in the beginning of the game, you won't really have the weapons, body armor, and things to help you get things done. So that's pretty much the only reason why things can be tough, but it's there and it's very frustrating for those just starting the game. Once you get past that though, very enjoyable. In terms of control, you'll definitely notice differences obviously between the PSP version and the console versions of GTA. But apart from a few hiccups, the game controls well for the most part. Obviously there's no second analog stick, so it's kind of funky when you have to, when you want to manually control the camera, you actually have to use the left analog nub or stick, whatever, in conjunction with the L button, so that's kind of weird. You actually have to stop and pan the camera manually, can't do it while you're running or anything, so that's kind of weird. When it comes to Liberty City's multiplayer, the game just shifts into high gear. Very impressive. Liberty City Stories offers a full-fledged console-like multiplayer experience packed with all the depth, strategy that console fans kind of expect of any game, really. You can choose to play 7 different modes with up to 4 different people. You have free reign over the 3 islands in the game, so you can pretty much go anywhere, hijack any vehicle, any weapon you want, it's all there. Of course, you don't purchase weapons in the multiplayer, you kind of find them strewn about the level as well as several power-ups that you can get, but again, it's very fun. In the end, Grand Theft Auto Liberty City Stories is a little rough around the edges in terms of control and things like that, but it still offers a deep, console-like GTA experience. There's so much to do that finishing the main story actually leaves around 60% of the game to experience, and that translates to 30-odd hours of gameplay. Just driving around the city and taking in the sights packs about as much fun as most full-fledged games, but you throw in the 7 multiplayer modes, a well-acted story, and a silly city filled with side quests and hidden extras, and you've got something special.